Molecules don't care about life. Nobody has ever seen molecules assemble toward life. Never. It doesn't happen without a biological entity working on them.
Now approaching lunar sunrise, and for all the people back on Earth, the crew of Apollo 8 has a message that we would like to send to you. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth.
In the beginning, there was nothing, and God said, "Let there be light," and there was still nothing, but now you can see it.
How did we get here? Think about the inexplicable series of events that brought you to this moment right now. There are an incomprehensible number of variables that need to happen just right in order to bring everything in our world into being. And if even one of those variables was a little different, life as we know it might not exist. But what is it that makes everything in our universe work? Armed with more knowledge than we've ever had before, can science finally explain the fundamental question of why we are here and how it all came to be? You're watching Matter, and today we're looking into why our universe is so perfect. Have you ever realized how perfect the universe seems to be? Everything exists and interacts in just the right way that conditions were made perfectly for humans to evolve and reach the point that we can ask these questions. We can see this perfection at nearly all levels of our existence. The Earth was made up of just the right materials and orbits at the right distance from the Sun in order to receive enough energy and warmth for life to grow and evolve. It is seen on larger scales. The strength of gravity is just strong enough that all the galaxies remain intact. The planets are held in orbit, and we stay put firmly on the ground. And even down to the scale of atoms and particles. The forces that control subatomic particles are balanced to allow all kinds of particles to exist and combine to form more complex. One of the goals of physics is to take all of these observations that have been made about our universe and be able to describe and predict them using mathematical laws and models. What are the constants of the universe? Physicists have learned that what happens in the universe is governed by a number of physical laws that can be expressed mathematically. A large percentage of these equations use particular numbers that science has dubbed fundamental constants that keep showing up again and again. Universal constants are specific values that are found throughout the universe. These values are not random. Most are quantities that have been measured experimentally, such as the speed of light, c, or the number pi, which relates the diameter of a circle to its circumference. These values remain constant no matter where they are found, and remain constant in all the equations of physics, chemistry, and other sciences. Constants are the key to how the universe is held together and how it functions, but we are still unsure why they have the values that they do. They exist at all levels of reality, down to the smallest scale using Planck's constant, all the way up to the macroscopic scale of the gravitational constant holding galaxies and solar systems together. It's actually believed by some scientists that if they are able to have a complete model of the universe, all of the many universal constants that have been found will be able to be combined into one universal constant. What do the constants mean? There are constants that govern the laws of the universe, and each scientific discipline has constants that are essential to their study. In physics, there are many constants used to describe the physical laws that govern reality. There's the gravitational constant G that shows up in Newton's equation for gravity that explains the gravitational interactions between two masses. There's Planck's constant H that shows up all over quantum physics. Physics today is built on top of these constants. All of the equations that describe reality today rely on these constants having the values that they do. If they were omitted from these equations, physics would cease to function and our understanding of the universe would be lost. These constants are so fundamental to science's understanding of the universe that there have been many discussions and attempts to understand why they have the values that they do. Scientists have not found that answer yet, but many of them have begun to wonder what would happen if the constants that run our universe were different. Scientists can now simulate what would happen if those constants came out different when our universe was born. Running simulations. With the help of the massive computing power available today, physicists have been able to code extremely complex and massive simulations of the universe. When all physical laws are transcribed into computer code, scientists get to watch a virtual Big Bang begin in their virtual universes. After a simulated universe has begun, scientists are able to watch these universes evolve over billions of years and see how matter behaves. Luckily, when they run the simulations with the laws of physics for our universe, the model ends up looking a whole lot like our own universe after 14 billion years. This is a great sign and means that science is on the right track with its understanding of the universe, and the laws that we know to control the universe are, at least mostly, correct. What would happen if they were different? But what if the universe was born different and had different fundamental constants? These simulations can also show scientists what would happen if the universe had been born according to slightly different rules. Maybe in one universe, gravity is a bit weaker, and after its virtual Big Bang goes off, nothing happens. With less gravity, stars would never form, and with no stars, there would be no stellar engines to undergo nuclear fusion in the universe. With no nuclear fusion, there is no hope of hydrogen turning into helium, nor any of the other elements that we find in our expansive universe. In the reverse, if gravity was stronger, all of the matter in the universe would condense much faster than it happened here, and if it was strong enough, the matter may condense into black holes quicker than any complex structures could form. Okay, well, what if gravity was the same, but dark energy, the mysterious force driving the expansion of the universe, was stronger? In this case, the more powerful dark energy could cause the universe to expand faster than gravity could ever pull together hydrogen atoms, leading to a vast universe devoid of any complexity. If dark energy was a bit weaker than it is, it may never have been strong enough to overtake gravity as the driving force in the universe, and gravity would end up drawing everything in the universe together in a single mass. No matter which constant or feature of the universe physicists changed in the simulation, the virtual universes ended up with no possibility of the complex universe we see today, which means that all of these universes would also never have a chance to develop life. If even one of these constants was different when our universe was born during the Big Bang, we would never have the opportunity to ask the questions that led our species to this point. Are we just lucky? Scientists and philosophers have been asking questions regarding the meaning of life and how everything came to be the way it is for all of recorded history. There have been many attempts to answer the questions of why our universe seems to be so perfectly tuned to have eventually led to us asking these questions. These answers have included theories of a grand designer having a hand in creating the universe with all its laws perfectly adjusted to allow life to grow. Some scientists are now focusing on the theory that we are all living in a simulation, that everything in our universe is nothing more than a simulation being run in another universe above ours. Considering that we can build a simulated universe, it is possible that as our technology gets better and computer processing power gets larger, these simulations could eventually be complex enough to allow simulated life to evolve. We may never be able to find out if our universe was made according to a specific guideline by a higher being, or if our universe was just lucky enough to win the lottery, being born with everything so perfectly balanced. But we do know that we exist here, and we get to explore this wondrous universe and discover all of the hidden secrets and mysteries it has to offer. What do you think started it all, and how did it become so perfectly balanced? Be sure to join us next time, and if you watched all the way to the end, we want to say thank you. And if you enjoyed this video, please feel free to hit the like and subscribe buttons so you won't miss out on any of our future videos.